Next, we are talking about MapReduce and how that integrates into Hadoop. So first, we have to understand the execution paradigm of MapReduce. The basic idea of MapReduce is to apply a processing pipeline consisting of two operations, map and reduce. Map basically filters and converts input records that you have to tuples, and reduce retrieves all these tuples with the same key. So Hadoop would then take care of reading the input files, distributing the key value that are produced from a map step to the reduce function. And you can configure basically in a job what types of key and value you would like to have, what kind of file formats you have, and so on. And then you trigger a map and reduce operation. So here's an example now, where we do word count. You want to count the words, frequencies in large texts. How often is the word the word king, and so on, into my text. So in the map function, we get a key, which is the position in the text, and we get a text, which is, for example, a line of text, if we're reading a CSV file, or a text file. And then we can say for each word in the text, we emit now one of these tuples, we emit word, comma one. So the key is word and the value is one, which is kind of the number of occurrence we have seen. In the reduction function, we get a signature key and a list of values. Now we actually know what key is. Key is one of these words that we have emitted in map. And list of values, these are the numbers which are, well, initially ones, right? So now we can count how often we see a certain word by setting count to zero, and then we say for each value in the values, which are should be all ones, by the way, we count increment count by v, which is one. And then we emit afterwards the word and the count. So therewith we can emit how often we have seen a word like the or count and so on. So as you see, it is not defined here in the execution how map and reduce are actually executed. As I said, Hadoop takes care of making sure that the semantics that I just explained to you is guaranteed to hold. Okay, so in map we produce key, we get keys in text in this example, or key values basically, and we emit key value tuples, and the reducer gets a key and a list of values in each call. So here's another example. What you want to do, you aggregate a CSV file by grouping entries. Okay, here we want to get rid of city. Okay, we want to group, for example, by country and state. Okay, in USA and California, how many people are there? Well, it's easy for us to see. In USA, California, we have 12. USA, California, we have 42 here in this other city. So we have totally 54. And this kind of aggregation that we just sketched here can be done with the MapReduce program here as pseudocode. Actually, it's a bit more like Python. So we get country, state, city, and population by splitting our CSV file. Right, this is our CSV file, remember, by comma. And then we emit a key, which is country and state. So as you can see, a key can be actually a compound. And then we emit the population. Now we get the key, which is of this form, country and state, and the values is the list of populations. Again, we sum it together and then we can emit it. So this produces basically this kind of output semantically. So how is this executed? There are different phases of the MapReduce execution. First of all, you have to distribute the code. We are talking about many kind of task trackers. And what we need to do is our job tracker that we want to run. We told the job tracker we want to run this application, our MapReduce program. It will distribute the code among all those task trackers that have to execute it. Next, it would have to figure out which files to read, which depends on the file blocks and file splits that we will see a bit later. And then we assign a mapper. We assign one mapper to each split. And slot. Then we invoke the map function on this data that we just have read, or we are just reading. Then there's another step, a new step that I haven't talked about so far, which is the combiner step. So we try to perform a local reduction by the key. Potentially, we can actually use quite the same reduction function for a combiner as we would use in the reducer later. Okay, now why do we do this kind of combination? We do it to reduce the network traffic. Okay, if you know on this huge amount of text that we read on this data block, I found the word king 14 times already. This is something instead of sending I found king one time, I found king one time, I found king one time, right? 14 times, which is much more data that needs to be transferred. So then we have a shuffle phase in which we sort by the key and we exchange the data between the mapper and the reducer. Next, we partition the key space among the reducers. This is done typically by hashing. So at this stage, we really now know, okay, this keys range, okay, key words A until, I don't know, king goes to reducer one, and until, and then the next word following king until, I don't know, zebra is sent to this other reducer. So you can in fact have multiple reducers in this system as well to parallelize this step too. Then you invoke those reducers on this individual keys and you write the output. And in this case, each reducer writes to its own file. Okay, if you find this a bit confusing already, you will see soon how this works and how easy it is to make it work.